Hey, did we level up? Oh, hey, we leveled up twice. Dang. Okay, then. Really? 22, 26, 30? Oh my god. Okay, then. We'll just upgrade. Upgrade. And upgrade. Perfect arena. And then now we can go do this main mission. Oh god. Okay, alright, we're good. Hey, I can call Roachy Roach now. Out of my way, Saris.
That's it, Roach.
King Gambit. What's that? Oh, I want to see what that is. Oh. This. A reward. Might as well go get our reward. I mean, we did all that. That was like 2 hours worth of two side quests, so. Might as well go get our fat and juicy reward. Right here. Okay. Croc, give me my reward, brah. The game is now and loading.
Master Geralt, a guard spotted you from the tower. They sent me to open the gate.
Why was it closed? Is that famous Skellige hospitality?
Me? 'Tis tradition. After the feast, the Jarls will choose the king, so the doors must remain closed. Only the sons and daughters of Skellige may stay in the castle.
Croc make an exception just for me?
All know what you did for Saris and Hjalmar. Today, you're one of us. Come. Croc awaits.
How's the mood in there?
Calm. Too calm.
How's that?
We've an adage here at Skellige. At a good feast, meat and blood flow in equal measure. Surely you consider this barbaric on the continent, no?
Not sure. Sounds preferable to dull banquets garnished with court intrigue.
Step careful there.
Interesting.
I've as much right to it as you do.
And I'd expect you to support me, not pinch my allies. If an uncrate's to wear the crown, it
should be you, because you've got fur growing on your chin, that it?
Show some of your own, and the Jarls just might listen to you.
What your mug smacked. Remember, I was left standing last time we crossed fists.
Yeah? So you'll fight the Vilkards with me? Wonder who'll do better, you or Hjalmar, the Giant Slayer?
Oh, stop your shite, Bolston!
Saris! Hey! God damn it!
Bad way to play it out.
Think I don't know that? But you saw her, she's so... so...
Stubborn, fierce, mule-headed. Refuses to listen to anyone.
Exactly! True, Arnvald. Me and Saris, well, they're twins in that regard.
Don't see Croc. He talking to the Jarls?
No, went to his chambers. To prepare your promised reward, no doubt.
If you've a spell witcher, perhaps you'd fancy some fisticuffs with the Vilkarls. Loosen up your joints after your journey.
Maybe later.
Give me my reward, bro.
Beautifully.
Don't mind me, just jumping on the food. It's only adding to the flavor of the delicious food.
Greetings, Berna. Feast not to your liking?
This is no feast. It's a farmer's market where votes are bought and sold like sheepskins.
Leaving Caer Troelda?
Tomorrow at daybreak. Enjoy yourself, Master Geralt.
May I?
You must, even. Come! I've been waiting for you. So, feast to your liking? Any better than your continental balls?
Definitely more to drink.
Aye, there is. Rolled all of it out of my cellars. Double meads, triple, Cintrian plum brandy, a Hackamum spirit that burns the mouth like boiling water. Clan on Crate knows the meaning of hospitality.
Feeling torn between Hjalmar and Ceres?
You mean, do I have a favorite? Nay, they're as different as fire and water. But on Crate blood flows in both.
Think the Council of Jarls will dare to put a woman on the throne?
If you'd asked me some months ago, I'd have laughed in your face. But today I see, and I'm not alone, that Ceres has something as rare on the isles as a hot summer. Patience. Others act, then think. She's different. She thinks things through, the for, the against. But once she takes action, not a force in the world could stop her.
Between you and me, Hjalmar's not too hot-headed to be king.
Depends on the kind of king you have in mind. Want one who'll send emissaries, move figurines about a map, calculate the most profitable option? And yes, he's too hot-headed. But Skellige wants a different ruler. The kind who'll drown Nilfgaard in blood. Sooner jump into a fire than surrender. And that is Hjalmar.
If you escalate your attacks, you stand to infuriate Ymir. Could regret it someday.
In Skellige, we spit on the notion of peace at any cost.
Promised me a reward for helping your children.
And I aim to keep my word. Here. This bauble's been in the family for generations. I give it to you for helping ensure the line endures.
Beautiful craftsmanship. Thanks.
I'm the one.
Are about to get serious. Got a new sword. Hopefully it's better than the one we currently have. I don't know if it's silver or steel though. Oh. Oh my god. Hey there. I just got done playing Far Cry 4 Valley of the Yetis. Wait. I'm overburdened. Chill. Oh my god. Yes. I don't want to drop this. We're too overweight though. That didn't even give us enough. Alright. Oh my god. Hey dude, just chill out. Let's be friends. I got this, guys. Don't worry. Dang, bro. Yo. Don't worry, guys. I'll do all the work here. It's fine. It's fine. Just make me do all the work. I thought those bears weren't that tough, in all honesty. They didn't really fight back. And it's not like they had a whole bunch of owls, so.
Cloth! Give me some cloth! Gotta stop the bleeding! Quick!
Da. Da.
Take my cloak.
Hold on, son. You'll pull through. A shark grabbed my leg once. Albion!
He's dead.
Crack! Where'd those bears come from, huh? Answer! Now!
Careful how you speak to my da.
Stow your blade, pup, or Crack will lose a son, too.
You insult me, Lugoth, and now you threaten my son. I will not step to this.
Dan, come here. Come on! Put you down like a rabid dog.
Calm down. Calm down. Enough blood's been spilt. Someone brought these beasts here to murder our sons and brothers. We cannot restore their lives, but we can, we must avenge them. This burden falls upon the host and his offspring.
Find the guilty on Crete, find and kill them, else your clan will be cursed for 100 generations to come.
Anybody see how the bears got in?
Don't matter. I know where to find the guilty already.
Wait! Are you mad? You're gonna kill folk before we've learned what happened.
Learn all you want. Meantime, I'll go wash the shame off our clan.
Hey, the Jarls aren't listening anymore. Stop playing the hero and think for a second.
Our honor's at stake, sis. That can't wait.
Are you listening to me? Someone let those bears in. We must know who, and the answer lies somewhere in this room.
You're right, Ceres. I'll help you.
Thanks.
Fine. See you when I return with the traitor's heads.
I'll stay here. Someone must see to everything. Summon the healer, hand the fallen over to their families. Wolf, I thank you.
Ever see anything like that?
No, and I hope I never will again.
Where'd the bears come from? We were all laughing, eating, drinking. Suddenly, a massacre. Torrents of blood on the walls.
What happened before the massacre? Be precise.
Young Lugoth bet he could empty a barrel of beer in one go. He climbed on the table, grabbed a pony keg of Sintern wheat, and started chugging. His throat bulged like a blowfish. Face went red, but he kept drinking. Folks started banging their tankards on the table, shouted, "Lugoth, Lugoth." Then, from the other side of the room, we heard this roar. We turned in unison as if a coxswain had called. They were there. They were already there. Folks closest to the bears didn't even manage to draw their weapons. They were ripped to shreds.
We'll avenge them, I promise. Know who died?
Drogadar, Dragborn Dhu, Blue Boy Lugoth, Jarlborn, Otrig. Take some time, mention them all.
But you could name the claimants to the throne who survived in one breath. You, Hjalmar, and Svanriga.
What are you saying?
Nothing, just yet. We've talked enough. Let's look around.
Let me know what you find. I'll speak to the others. Maybe someone saw more than I did.
Okay. This is quite interesting.
Fang marks, claw marks, broken bones. Hard to say what exactly killed him.
The gates were shut!
What? Okay. This is a really long, like, side quest story.
Turn back around.
All right. What do we have here?
Examine head.
Bear's head, but the tongue's short, like a human's. Mouth smells of honey liqueur. Mead. And something else. Something earthy.
Earthy.
Bears like honey. Before it's fermented. Strange.
Torso.
Something under the fur. A tattoo. Shape of a bear paw.
Yo, these are like humans turned
old
bears.
Scar. Looks like it was sutured.
That's
half
exactly
man,
what this
half bear. Something like a lycanthrope. No full moon, so something else caused the transformation. Maybe something he ate or drank. Mead. Mead with an earthy aroma. Need to check the horns, tankards, and bowls.
Great. Examine the traces of mead around the crime scene using your Witcher senses.
All the horns are empty.
Oh.
Bowl at each table. Mead in this one.
So the tales are true.
And only mead.
Warriors and transformed into wild beasts.
Earthy scent from the bear's maw. Something towards mushrooms, bowls empty, wounds. But the sense in the
air,
Hjalborn bled to death.
He's talking twice.
Somewhere else in this room.
Okay, okay. What? Oh. What's this?
Here. Mead spiked with some kind of mushroom. And human blood.
Ceres, come here.
A guard saw what happened. Those weren't bears. They were...
men who transform into bears.
Uh-huh. Berserkers.
Berserkers?
The Skald's name for warriors who change into animals in the midst of battle. The stuff of fairy tales, legends. But it seems to make sense, right?
Mm-hmm. Almost. We were at a feast, not on a battlefield. Think I know what caused them to transform. The mead they drank. Smell this. Mead spiked with blood, and something else. Thinking it could be a mushroom, but I don't recognize the type.
Hjort might help us. Few druids know herbs better.
Can't hurt to try.
Ask Hjort to have a look at the mead sample.
A disgrace. The camp we've not seen since the Red Funeral.
Shut up. Sorry to cut you off, dude.
May the sea swallow the traitors. Freyr, our lady.
Mind if I interrupt?
Already have? What is it?
Someone spiked one of the mead barrels with blood and something else. An herb or a mushroom. Ceres said...
Give me the horn. I know the smell. A mushroom. Mardrom.
Mardrom. Never heard of it.
You've another name for it on the continent. Psilocybe, I believe.
All right. Peasants eat it to soothe pain.
Udalric tried it too, but only a few times. In larger doses, the mushroom causes visions, nightmares.
Yes, the last thing Udalric needed more of. Thanks for your help. Blood and mardrum. The taste of human flesh and a substance that triggers visions. That well could have caused the rage. Maybe even the transformation.
Maybe. Hard to believe someone spiked the mead here in the hall, though, in front of all those witnesses.
You're right. I helped prepare for the feast. I'd have noticed. It might have happened before they brought the drink upstairs. In the cellars, maybe? Come on, we could find some clues there.